Hello and welcome back to the Dark Souls 2 blind playthrough. No, I'm kidding. It's the Bloodborne playthrough. Yeah, that's where we are. I've not said Dark Souls 2 blind playthrough in like over a year, but here and today I needed to say it. So I was wondering if we could open this yet. Can't. So there you go. Those of you who were wondering about that gate, we've not looked and checked for a long while. It's still closed, sadly. We are currently on 20 insight. We're halfway to the 40, which is where apparently something will happen. I do have many stored up, as I've said many times, but you know, you all want to keep reminding me. Yes, I'm aware of the Madman's Knowledges. No, I'm not popping them, because it's pointless to pop them right now. It serves no purpose except not letting me use them later if I ever need them. There's no reason to do it yet. Relax. Okay, that's not most of you who are saying that, by the way. You're just going to have to forgive me, the majority of you who are calm and reasonable people. Alright, finally, the one other thing we need to do before we progress and go to, you know, other places, is apparently, go back to my previous cross-dressing cell days, you know, as I did that for like a little bit in an episode, did a bit of cross-dressing, whatever. And apparently I need to go speak to the doll because you guys are desperately wanting to see this happen right here. But I'll be honest with you, I don't think anything's gonna happen.
Welcome home, good hunter. What is it you desire?
Well, one of us is gonna have to change.
Hunters have told me about the church, about the gods and their love. But do the gods love their creations? I am a doll created by you humans. Would you ever think to love me? Of course. I do love you. Isn't that how you've made me?
Very interesting.
Hunters have told her, but I...
So they do worship the gods, the old ones, the great ones, whatever. That's just a given now. We've decided that that is just the case.
Farewell, good hunt. May you...
Actually, I need to level up, bro. yeah, apparently, yeah, they just worship the gods, the great ones. That's just the people of this land. They just do, straight up. So, there you go, I guess. I was a bit shocked by it, but there were a few things that, you know, sort of indicate that. And, you know, it really came to grounds when we walked into the bell tower where we faced the vicar. And there was those statues of the great ones, which were... very creepy. Let's go back to being fancy, shall we? It's been a while since we've worn this hunter garb, and it's quite nice looking, so why not? Yeah, so apparently, guys, cross-dressing, talking to her in her own clothes or whatever, she has no reaction. She gives zero Fs, okay? Zero Fs! So I have returned now to Uden Chapel, Cathedral Ward. I'm going to have a quick word with everyone here and see if there's anything new to be had in the dialogue.
Survivors.
All right, so we know that one. The dweller there believes there are no more survivors.
Oh, hello. Sorry, dear. You're much too eager. I've only so much blood, okay?
All right, nothing new there. Here's something new. Here's something very new. The old woman, she's cowering. Why are you cowering?
How did we ever get into this mess?
Oh no, she's going mad. She must be infected as well, right? Surely. Maybe she's turning into a beast, I don't know. Okay, so in the last episode I kind of looked at this chick and was like, meh. Walked past. I didn't see her. I legitimately didn't notice her. You know, she's in that dark corner with the dark clothes. This is the member of the healing church that we saved in the jail area. We did free her. And here she is. This is what she looks like when she's not cowering. She looks quite happy. I guess, I mean, getting out of that scary ass area, I'd be happy too.
Oh, brave hunter. You're alive.
Dapper too.
Thank you very much.
The female version of a church bow.
The town is in disarray, but there are still people here. Together we await the help of the healing church.
That ain't gonna... It's not gonna happen.
I cannot begin to express...
It only helps my help.
The only thing that I can offer is my own lowly blood.
Why does everyone want to give me their blood? Suffice. Jesus Christ. Fine, give me your blood. I've already received blood. Alright, okay, so I can only have one blood thing at any one given time. So I'm going to go ahead and drop this off. I'm going to start using this blood now, okay? Don't really know what it's going to do. Ah, yeah, it does give you a description. It's just been a while since I've read it. Temporarily boosts stamina recovery. So, in a boss fight or whatever, probably a good idea. Okay, so we're back at the crossroads here. Went in there and destroyed the vicar. Apparently I was over-leveled for it. As I was saying, I went into the jail area and I was supposed to defeat Dark Beast around level 50 or 40, 45 to 50 plus or something like that, turns out. And I obviously went there around 35 and defeated him around that point. So obviously it was a lot harder for me to fight Pal, and that's probably why I had so many struggles with him. Plus him being kind of a weird enemy, but you know, the dog type, that body type, beast type, it's not that bad to deal with, and I have had a lot of experience with it in the previous games, so I should have really not had to die to him, like, what, two or three times, whatever it was. Either way, I did beat it in the end, and I was under-leveled, so that's good. But I was over-leveling the vicar, apparently, and I guess I was supposed to be around level 30-something when I was there, so maybe that's why it was easier. Either way, you know, you can choose your own path in these games, and I'm opting to go left now. Into these barbed grassy areas. My bald hunter's marks. I was hoping to provide some sort of lore on this area. But press on. There are more gravestones here. There are gravestones everywhere in this bloody place. It looks like we're going into a cave. So I was expecting something to come out of that grass. Nip me in the back. But no, nothing happened. What is this place? Why is there a cave here? We have more gravestones. So it's just an area where we found more places to bury the many, many dead. On the hunt, we hunt the beasts. We bury the beasts. We burn the beasts. We bury the dead. We bury the beasts. There are many people to bury at all times in this world. People die a lot. Fuck is that? Another different type of mangy dog, it would seem. Welcome to the woods. There's a sniper over there. I'm gonna go deal with him. Yes, I need 10k souls to get Ludwig's, what? What is that over there? Oh my god, what is that thing? There's a lot of enemies in here. My previous thoughts and all that, they're gone for now. Something to do with Ludwig's, Ludwig's rifle. I will finish that thought soon, I promise. I'm just a little bit distracted. What the fuck is that thing? Look at that thing! Look at it! It's so creepy! I approve. Creepy as fuck, man. Okay. Alright. Keep your bearings. Okay, so it was screaming. It was thin. And it was dark. A little bit sort of like black colouring and all that. But, you know, that's a lot. We see a lot of that. But note the lycans. Lycanthrope. The werewolves. Whatever they are. They are often black. Black of hair. Oh, fuck! Alright, there's pots to blow up here. That's probably why there's so many of these asshole guys with guns. They're trolls! There's two over here. Another one elsewhere to my right. Careful positioning there, mate. I noticed that your friend was stood here. You stood on the other side and that. So that I would try and swipe at you and not be able to hit you behind the graves. Yeah, I know how you work, you jerk. Get a lot of this bone marrow ash that's going to increase the damage of our shots on guns. Yeah, I'm feeling kind of okay right now, so I'll finish my thought. Where did you come from? Dick. Okay, yeah, I got all the bullets I could possibly carry. Oh, we have another ritual happening here. Summoning another big guy. But I'm not, I don't think he's relevant. Sure, he's scary and all that, but these guys are much more dangerous. Ow! I bet they've got a nasty grab attack, these things. Oh my god, he swung like... He's still going! Jesus, he swung like 15 times. Calm down, mate. These L2 power attacks deal with you very nicely, thanks to the stagger. Let's have a jump finish, yeah? Haha. Oh, he fades into mist. His body completely, just goes out. Ooh. A new gemstone type. The cursed tempering blood gemstone. A blood gem that fortifies weapons, blah, blah, blah. Most triangular blood gems have effect that provides attribute bonuses and extra effects. So it's a triangle shape. Our first triangle shape. 6.6 physical attack up. And, oh, attack versus beast down. That's why. It's pretty bad, right? Pretty rough. But the base damage against other enemies is very interesting. Why is it that they have that? Oh, thick cold blood. Yeah, look at this. Level 4 thick cold blood. We were getting frenzied cold blood, which is level 8 in the jail area. We're on down to 4 now. This area is significantly easier for us because we're over-leveling it. I'm sorry I didn't go the correct path, I guess. But it provided a little bit more entertainment because, you know, I went and did something much harder and actually beat it. So we have more graves over here. Sort of weird, like, rituals. As if they're being revived, those skinny things. Now these dogs, whatever they are, they're dark and almost rat-like. They do have like a porcupine sort of feel to them because they're spikes, or hedgehog style, I guess. I'm searching every corner, man. This is these bullets, isn't it? Yeah. It's annoying that I'm sort of capped out on bullets. Like, completely and utterly. Ah, loot. Ah, nice. Well, actually, we don't need those, but hey. I wouldn't pass them up. Let's keep my eyes open for as much loot as I can. You know, I might have a second weapon at some point that needs upgrading, for example. You're a creepy looking motherfucker. I gotta say, your face was all dark and hairy. Are you gonna turn into those little sort of rat people? Do you think maybe that's what they are? The gun guys, they turned into those little rats, sort of porcupine dogs which have been fighting in this area. Just trying to take in the environment a little bit. What is up there? I think that's the 4G thing. Where we saw a lot of light coming from. Looked like people were still in there doing some construction or whatever, which wouldn't make sense if everyone's insane, but, you know, I guess we'll find out at some point. Oh! You're right, mate. I'm gonna give you a power attack. Congratulations. I hope you enjoyed. It was for you. Hey, fuck you. Alright, mate. Alright, fuck you. Jesus Christ. He's on that sweet spot where I couldn't hit him. There we go. I love their death animation. It's brilliant. So, Ludwig's Holy Blade. Yeah, I'm using that. I was going to talk about Ludwig's rifle. Didn't realize he had one until recently. 10k souls it costs. I will be getting it, hopefully this episode, and using it. It's ultimately the blunderbuss, but upgraded, apparently, according to you guys. Thank you very much for that information. Just noticed I'm down to 2 blood vials. Better start taking this shit seriously. There's some sort of manor there on the hill leading through this valley and the woods. I suppose that's where we're going to end up as our aim. If we could find some sort of lantern along the way here, I'd be very fucking appreciative. Ah, right there. Perfect. Yeah, I was just thinking, you know, it's been a while since we've seen that. Hemwick Charnel Lane. Okay, this is a lot bigger than I thought it was. I thought I was just going to go over to that thing, go in it. Look at this. There's actually this sort of, like, town here. Reminds me of Old Yharnam. Screams. Laughter. What the fuck? What the fuck? We've got 2 people just having a little bit of a dance in a circle over here. We got someone over here who's completely mad, who's screaming. That person's pretty chill over there. A pile of gravestones. Weird statue. God, it's just, this place is essentially just a graveyard that they're living in. An abandoned house here. A tower. Nice bridge or tunnel there that leads into under that, like, mountainy hilly bit. Bit more of the town over there. In the distance, that big keep. Objective. Well, let's press on. Thought there'd be something happening because of this lantern here. But no. Alright. Let's press on. Oh god. There's another one on the right as well on the ground I didn't see. See if we can get a better look at them. That one's crying so weirdly. Sounds like a man, but it's a woman, right? Okay, they're fast. They die in two light attack hits. One power attack, but not like a charge one. It's a normal power attack. No problem. But they're fast. They're women as well, yes. Or once were, at least. Whatever they are now. Hello. Come get it, sickle woman. That's it. Instant death to an L2. Okay, good to know. Easy enemies. They're just villagers. They're just Yharnamites, essentially. Except they live on the outskirts. I love that weapon, by the way. Look at how glorious that thing looks. Looks so fucking cool. Don't really know why I'm doing power attacks. We've already acknowledged they're very easy to kill. I don't need to waste that time. But their weapons, the way they glow. Very cool. They've singed them. To the point of the glowing hot embers. They will burn us. They will cauterize the wound as well while they do it. Alright, we got bodies here. People in body bags hanging. Why? We don't know yet, but the survivors of this area have gone fucking batshit insane. And there is a lot of bodies hanging from this. There's bodies everywhere. You know, there's a lot of them buried. Wasn't expecting to find anyone sane here. Another madman's knowledge there. Some sort of contraption over there. Wasn't expecting to find anyone sane here. Happy to have found them. Sounds like a zombie, man. That doesn't seem sane. Alright, that's not sane at all. I take it back. I was like, there's no way someone's going to be sane here, right? I mean, look at what we've seen so far. At some point, they were sane. And they put the incense lamp outside of their little home. And I guess they went mad while inside. I think that's what's happening to... Yeah, I thought so. I could hear you coming. I went near that loot and I was going to get ambushed. Clever game. I think that's what's happening to the old woman that we saved. Oh, more triangular gemstones. Interesting. Yeah, I think that's what's happening to the old woman in the Uden Chapel, the one that we saved. Oh, another eyeball there for more chalice stuff. Perhaps she is losing her mind in a similar way to these people. Alright, we got another one of these gangly mother truckers. They look, they remind me a little bit of the crazy woman now. Maybe these are the crazy woman turned into beasts, do you think? Seems like a very different sort of style of beast transformation compared to that of, you know, the other beast transformations we've seen in Yharnam. Everyone seems taller and more gangly, even the beasts themselves, even the transformed dogs. I think that's very interesting. They're just a taller, gangly people. Those who live on the outskirts. Jesus fucking Christ. You're right there, crazy woman. Looks kind of like a witch or a hag with a many, many Molotovs up there. I guess I'll go say hi. I'll deal with you first. You with your goddamn hammer over here. Now, can you stop that, you hag? How dare you? Jesus. Nice, more blood vials. Desperately hanging on to the vials I do have, but I have a very small number. I'm fully aware of that, so I'm taking it very carefully, very cautiously. Another lamp here. No incense, though. I'm going to quick look around this graveyard. Make sure I'm not missing anything. There is that contraption back where that house was. I will go back to that at some point. Don't worry. Just wanted to acknowledge that now. Before people are upset about it in the comments or whatever. This, just another graveyard. How many graveyards can you possibly have in one town? Like, the majority... Oh, God. Sneaky bastard. The majority of the people who lived here are dead. Are fucking dead. And by the way, come at me, bro. Jesus Christ. Yeah, they're all dead. Everyone who lived here, the populace of this town, most of them have died. Surely, based on this. And no wonder they've fucking gone mad. More twin... Wow. You can get a few here. Don't need to farm them, guys. Just go to the jail area, get a few... Oh my god, another one. Go to the jail area, just grab a few. You know how it goes. And then, come here. And you got all the ones you can possibly need. It's pretty good. But yes, Ludwig's rifle. Looking definitely to get that. Can I hear something big in there? Ah, there it is. Oh, it's an executioner! We've only seen one in the whole game, and I was wondering, you know, why are they there? Who are they? They're very different. And they're almost like the ogres. The big ogres, like the one that I just killed there in that charge. Told him to come at me. Can hear someone down there. They're like them, but more intelligent, perhaps? Less stupid? God, look at the gravestones. They're fucking everywhere. Even there. Who climbed up there to bury someone there? Honestly. I knew I could hear someone, by the way. Jesus Christ. You're alright, love. Ah, that didn't sound... You don't sound alright. I thought there'd be, you know, like the... like the loot that was up here. Down this way. Down there. I was thinking, oh, look. I can see I can climb on this bit. Yeah, there'll be loot up here, probably. Let's... Hop over here. Aw. Alright, can't do that. But I had to try. Crows. Get it! There must be more. They're always in packs, the crows. They're always in a flock, I suppose. A flock of crow. I thought someone was going to try and knock me off the edge there. It's one of these monsters again. Don't know what to call them, guys. Sure they have a name. Yeah, over here, mate. Oi. Oi. Dipshit. Yeah, me. Talking to you. Rude. Right, you're not getting me in one of those crazy combos. Don't let yourself think that you are. It's not gonna happen. Come get it. Thank you. See you next time. They give us a lot of gemstones. That's good. Powerful ones. I'll probably have to replace the ones that are in my weapon. Up, more crows. But they don't give me any insight onto what they are. And I've noticed that a lot the most in Bloodborne, which is kind of lame, I think. Oh, there's another one there. How did I miss you? You know, in the other Souls games or whatever, you'd see a lot of armor sets drop off enemies. You could farm them, whatever. And it's good and bad that they've removed that, because it was kind of a pain in the ass to have to farm the same enemy for ages to get its armor set. Now you just sort of, like, buy it from the shop when you kill the enemy enough, you know. Whatever. I like that. But I do not like the fact that because we're missing out on farming people for their specific armor sets and weapons and stuff, we don't get to have an item where there's lore on it that tells us specific information about what they are, who they are, etc. We have a lift here. Why not? Oh, I was expecting to go up, not down. Minor regret. Oh, right, look at that. That was convenient. Yes, this contraption we saw over here, it's the lift. We just unlocked a shortcut. That was pretty good. Making nice progress through this town, I must say. See if we can sort of like get through most of it in one episode. That'd be cool. You know, I often take my fucking sweet time, don't I, when getting through these areas. And, you know, it's good to pay attention to things, make theories, you know, but as long as I'm still doing that while I'm going like I am now, you know, I think it's fine that I'm making some nice progress and being pretty quick. Getting a lot of this bone marrow ash. That is... Oh, hang on. You're right, mate. Sometimes they say something, and I'm always very interested to listen to them because I want to know how these ogres, these big fucks, came to be. Additional medium that strengthens... Yeah, it strengthens quick silver bullets. According to the workshop, this is a special bone marrow, ash collected from Hemwick Charnel Lane. So this is why I'm getting so much of it. This is where it's made. I would love to know why. Now, we saw a lot of those gun guys, you know, in that valley where we first saw the new enemy, the new beast type, whatever it is. You are one creepy motherfucker. The way they move and come out of the darkness like that scares the shit out of me, man. Going in there, I'm not looking forward to it, I gotta say. I see people laying down, and I don't believe for a second they're dead. Oh my god. Listen to this. FromSoft, you bastards! You know how to make a creepy game, don't you? The whole time I'm going to be in this dark area, I'm going to be listening to this, aren't I? The creakiness of these doors. Well, fuck you, dark area. Pulling out my torch, and we're going to use our one-hand sword for the first time in a while. Welcome to the first barn of the game. Oh, wait! Oh, wait! Oh, wait! Oh, wait! Oh, wait! Fire! Yeah, so I did that a lot in the stream. When I went to Old Yharnam, I was just pretending to be one of the Yharnamites, there we go, with their fucking torches going, away, away, you know. Jesus Christ. Speaking of away, 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 away. I love doing that because they have unique death animations. When you kill them with fire, sure, it's not the most effective way to kill people, but I love the animations that they have when you kill them with fire. Like that woman, you know, she screamed fire when she died. We wouldn't have heard that if I hadn't tried it. Oh, come on, this is ambush shitty right here. I can hear a wheelchair above me. Or somewhere in here, I suppose. But it sounded like it was above me. I hear you, oh! Yeah, fuck you, bro. I know your games. This is what getting... What paying attention gets you. You know when they're gonna get you and where from. Alright. Hang on a sec. Ah, there we go. I was like, I don't want to leave. I want to go back to the wheelchair area guy. But it looks like I'm gonna have to go that way to get to it. I can hear someone breathing in here. Oh, shit! Did it. That was, impressive. Come on, give me that. Really? You got stuck perfectly as well. Fuck you. Thank you. Nice. That insta-kills them pretty much. Mob bloodshot eyeballs. We see that, it seems like maybe a little bit of experimenting went here. You know, you can see that there was some studying going on with the sickle next to it. We got a potion of some kind, some sort of vial. Lots of books. Maybe not necessarily experimenting, but definitely some sort of study of some kind. We have an axe here. Hunter's axe? God, I can hear a lot of breathing. Maybe outside or above us. Let's go that other way then. Let's keep exploring. Make sure we don't leave any page unturned. I'm so going to get shot when I cross this, aren't I? Oh no. I'm okay. Where's the wheelchair guy? I know he's here. There he is. You're right, mate. How you doing? I love these as a new enemy. I love them. They're so fucking sneaky with them. I absolutely adore it. I really like Bloodborne, guys. I gotta say. I'm so fucking impressed with this game. Just every level of detail. The creepiness. Those banging doors. The environments. They change so much. You get to see so much different variety. And yet, the whole color scheme of this game is very similar the whole way through, right? Yet, there's so much variety and colourfulness to the game. I don't know how that happens, and I'm sure I'm not explaining myself properly, but I just really am enjoying the atmosphere. It's got to be one of my favourite experiences in gaming completely so far. Maybe it's just me, but I'm pretty sure this game's pretty successful. Now, I heard some deep breathing above me still, even then when I was inside, but can't see them now. Alright, we have this huge building over there, and a broken bridge that was once leading to it. Hang on, is that water there? We haven't seen that in Bloodborne yet. It's not, like, super exciting. Oh, wow! Look at that! Oh god, I love how it looks. Okay. Yeah, look. Actually, water down there. I don't think we've seen... Yes, we haven't seen it in Old Yharnam, down in the valley, and it was a tiny trickle of a stream. But this, right here. We must be on the edge of the island. In fact, no, you can see on the other side, there is a wall over there. Perhaps this is a lake. Still, I'm very interested in learning about this area. You know, this is where they made the bone marrow ash, which empowers weapons. Specifically guns. You're right, love. Nice mallet. It's my sword. Sword's better. Oh, you die. Yeah. I want to know why... Who made the bone marrow ash? Why was it specific to this area? This village? This hamlet? Was there some sort of person, some sort of experimenter, some sort of scientist who was the sort of key player behind making this place successful? You know, once this... At one point, I'm sure this place was successful. And I'm sure the fact that they were the producers of the bone marrow ash had something to do with it. You know, a unique resource that you couldn't get anywhere else. Bone marrow ash. And they'd have to come here to purchase it. So it's a very important place. Wow, I was really expecting to stagger you, but I suppose that was a big jump there, mate. Well done. Thanks for the heals. I'm gonna need them. Oh god, I love the way it burns so red and orange. See the heat in the weapon. We got another beast over there. Whatever it is. We haven't been inside the building. I'm sure there's a way in. There was two paths. We took the outside one first. You know how I like to do things. I go around the outside first. Beast first. You're alive. Holy crap. Impressive. Oh, so many twin shards. I can't let her live. She just can't let it live. Where'd she go? She's somewhere. There she is. I can't hear her. All right, I'd have to drop down, and not sure I could come back from that. Oh my god, the grab! Another grab attack there. Another sneaky grab. That one I actually avoided, though. Happy about that. It's all your fault. Jesus Christ, she scared the shit out of me, even though she didn't land the grab. Bit dark in here, innit? We can hear a deep sort of guttural breathing coming from this tower. We were near it. We were on the outside of it earlier. And I want you to note that there was a lot of bodies hanging outside the building. And inside, there's a lot of bodies in these same bags. Maybe there's some sort of beast in here that they were feeding the corpses with. Look at how many there are. Whatever it is, it sounds like it's asleep, maybe. So many bodies on that pile there on the right. It's not in here, it's outside, but... Oh, it's just the executioners. Never mind then. I thought they were feeding some sort of beast. Fuck though, dude. There's so many bodies here. Alright. I can't go that way yet. I still haven't explored the inside of that main building that we're next to. As I was saying, I went outside rather than inside. So let's go have a quick glance on the inside. Very interesting area. Really liking this whole area. Actually, I prefer it to Old Yharnam. You know, we were talking about Old Yharnam earlier. Not long ago, just when we're on this bit. And if I was to compare the areas, I would say this one feels much more interesting to me. There's a lot more questions, and the creepiness of how the characters seem to be insane. I love it. Oh, okay. Shit, never mind then, I was completely wrong. It looked like there was a path this way, maybe to go inside. It's just a dead end. Blind playthrough, boys. Alright, you know what? We've made some serious progress today. Done really well. Got through this valley very quickly. Very happy about it. But I gotta leave it there. You know, we've got this huge building that we're very close to getting into. This will be next time. Oh, look. Seems like there's crows flying over it. We've not seen any birds of any nature, I don't think, that haven't been deformed and, broken like the crows that we fight. The giant ones. But to see ones that actually are flying. Surely something's in there alive that's worth flying around. They're not vultures. The vultures would be eating all the bodies. Oh man, I didn't even see that. The bodies hanging there. God damn it. It's so grim, this whole valley. But whatever that big building is, we're going to be exploring it next time, I'm sure. Once we make it through this field of executioners. We fought one and had a hard time of it. Now we've got to fight what? At least four? And also the Molotov woman? God damn. Either way, guys, I've been Hollow, you've been you. If you've enjoyed today's episode, please leave a like. It helps greatly. And I will see you next time for some more Bloodborne.